Hello friends, this is Reeta here. So today I'm going to do a video on one of the important topic of Karnataka history, which is related to KPSC mains and prelims perspective or any other exams related to KPSC, that is regarding the Chalukyas. In the previous two videos, we have seen regarding the Kadambas and also the Western Gangas, their architecture, literature and religion. So in this video, we are going to see about the Chalukyas, their architecture, especially the temple architecture. And also we are going to see the literature and religion. So if you have any doubts regarding KPSC exams, or if you need any materials regarding the KPSC exams, or if you want to have the KPSC daily current affairs, you can just browse through the KAS Moksha, which is an Inspiro IASKS initiative, or else you can WhatsApp or call to the number which is present on the screen. So let's start. So as we see this, Chalukyas, so the reign of Chalukyas began a new era in the history of Karnataka, and these Chalukyas, they ruled over 2.5 centuries and they united the whole of South under an empire. So for how many centuries they have ruled? So they have ruled over 2.5 centuries, and few of the rulers, they fought a prolonged battle with the Pallavas to gain the supremacy of Chalukyas in the South India. So if you see the capital of Chalukyas, so the capital of Chalukyas is Vatapi or Badami, so which is a district which was present in Bijapur district. And we could see the history of Chalukyas from 6th to 12th century AD, and it can be studied under three classifications, that is Chalukyas of Badami, Chalukyas of Kalyani and Chalukyas of Vengi. So here important thing you have to remember that Chalukyas ruled over 2.5 centuries and the capital is Vatapi or Badami of Bijapur district. And next let's see who are the rulers. So if you see the rulers of Chalukyas, so the first founder of this dynasty is Jayasimha, and later Ranaranga succeeded him. So that is Jayasimha was succeeded by Ranaranga, who is a son. And next later the son of Ranaranga, that is Pulakesi I, who was the first Chalukyan to rule independently in South India. And this Pulakesi I gained so many titles. So titles included Satyashraya, Ranavikrama and Sri Prithvi Vallabha. So these are the titles that were given to Pulakesi I, who was a first Chalukyan to rule independently. So later we could see Pulakesi I's son Kirti Varma came into rule. So after the death of Kirti Varma, as his sons were so young to rule the kingdom, so what happened, his brother Mangalesha started to rule the Chalukyas. So then after when Kirti Varma's sons got into the age where they are capable of ruling the kingdom, so that time Pulakesi II defeated Mangalesha and he came to the power. So and Pulakesi II was also one of the great and famous ruler of Chalukyas, and he got the titles, or he was represented with many titles. So the titles included Vallabha, Prithvi Vallabha, Parameshwara and Dakshinapateshwara. So these are the titles that were given to Pulakesi II. So here important rulers you need to remember are Pulakesi I and Pulakesi II, what were their titles. So next let us see the important topic of this, important part of this topic, that is art and architecture. So as we see that in the history of Indian art, the Chalukyan art has a pride of place. So here we can see there are three different temple styles, that is Nagara style, Dravida style and Vesara style. So Nagara style in North India, Dravida style in South India, and Vesara style we could see this style of temples built only in Karnataka. So here we see what is Vesara style. So Vesara style is nothing but the combination of northern and southern styles. So this took birth in northern Karnataka, that too during Chalukya period. So that is what we call this style as also the Chalukyan style. So if you see the Chalukyan monuments, so they are assembled in two classes, that included rocket halls or rocket temples. And next we can see the structural temples also built during this Chalukyan period. So in this background, so Percy Brown, so who was a historian, he called this architecture, that is the Chalukyan architecture, as a cradle of Indian temple architecture. So here, if you see the Chalukyan architecture, the important centers of their art are Badami, Aihole and Pattadakal. So let us see what are the important temples in each of the centers. So what are the important temples of Badami and Aihole and also Pattadakal? So first, before that, we need to see what are the important characteristic features of the temple architecture of Chalukyas. So if you see the Chalukyan temple architecture, they have a small base design and a horseshoe base, and they had square garbhagriha. So garbhagriha was placed where the main deity was placed, and next we could see the inner pradakshinapatha, mukhamantapa, navaranga and shukanasi, and next we could see the pyramidical shikhara on the garbhagriha. So on the garbhagriha we could see pyramidical shikhara. So this pyramidical shikhara we can also call it as vimana when it comes to the South Indian style of architecture. And also one of the important feature we see here is ekuta, dvikuta and trikuta temples can be seen in Chalukyan architectures. So these are some of the important characteristic features what we could see, the most common things in all the Chalukyan temples. So the first one we'll see, as I have told you, Badami was one of the center of art. So the first is cave temples of Badami. So there are four rocket cave temples at Badami. So cave number one, they belong to Shaivism. That is, so in this Shaivism also, the important sculptures or the notable sculptures include Ardhanarishwara and Shivalila. And cave number two and three, so that belongs to Vaishnavism. So in this cave number 2 and 3. In cave number 2, we can see Varaha and Vamana base reliefs. And cave number 3 is the biggest of all the four caves. And this cave number 3 is built by Mangalesha. And next we could see cave number 4. So this cave number 4 belongs to Jainism. And smallest cave sculpture. So this is one of the smallest cave sculpture. Smallest cave. And here we could see the sculptures of Mahavira and Pashvanatha, who was the 23rd. Tirthankara. So this is the information regarding the cave temples of Badami. Here the picture you could see the cave temples of Badami. So cave number 1 Shaivism, cave number 2 and 3 Vaishnavism, and cave number 4 Jainism. So next let's see the temples of Chalukyan art, that is Aihole. So what are the temples at Aihole? So the first thing we see is Ladkan temple. So it is the first of the temple of Chalukyan art. So it has mandapa, as you could see the right side of the first picture, you could see a mandapa and also the garbhagriha. So in the next picture you could see Nandi. So this Nandi idol is in front of the garbhagriha, and also we could see in the second picture, that is down the Ladkan temple, you could see one more picture down. So there, so I'll just zoom it. So here you could see the picture of Garuda at the entrance of the garbhagriha. So this is garbhagriha, and here you could see the picture of picture of Garuda at the entrance of garbhagriha, and here you could see the idol of Nandi which is straight towards the garbhagriha, and here you can also find the mukhamantapa and also the garbhagriha. So this is one of the important temple of Chalukyan art, Aihole. So next temple we could see is Durga temple. So this is very special temple among the temples of Aihole. So this is similar to the Sun Temple Konark, Odisha. So here this temple was designed on the model of horseshoe and Buddhist Chaityalayas. So here if you see the structure of this temple, it resembles the horseshoes. So here we see the shikhara of this temple. So here whatever the shikhara is there, so this part we call it as shikhara. So this part is shikhara. So this particular part resembles the Sun temple or the shikharas of Orissa temple. And also we could see Ranga Mandapa with two rows of pillars and a veranda on the two sides go to the garbhagriha and merge in the semicircle. So here you could see all the surrounding of this mantapa, so were provided with the pillars. So these pillars merge in the semicircle. So why we call this temple as Durga temple means this temple is surrounded by fort wall and it is called as fort temple or also Durga temple. So this is one of the best example of temples of Chalukyan and Aihole, that is Durga temple. So next we see is Meghuthi Jaina temple. So this temple was built by Ravi Kirti. So here you could see on the eastern wall of this temple is written Aihole inscription. So if you see here, so this eastern wall of the temple contains the Aihole inscriptions, and this temple has Mukhamantapa and Madhya Rangamantapa, and Garbhagriha is built in Dravida style. So these features are important. We need to remember these features to fetch a good marks. That is, the temple has Mukhamantapa, Madhyaranga Mantapa and Garbhagriha is built in Dravida style. So this is one of the example of Aihole temples of Chalukyanad. So we have seen, first thing is Durga temple, Ladakan temple and Meghuthi Jaina temple. So next let's see one of the important center of arts, that is Pattadakallu. So here if you see in Pattadakallu, what are the temples in Nagara styles? They are Kashi Vishwanatha, Papanatha, Jambulingeshwara temple. So these are the temples. So those were in Nagara style in Pattadakallu. And we could say Sangameshwara temple, Virupaksha temple and Mallikarjuna temple, which were present in Dravida styles in Pattadakallu. So one of the noteworthy temple what we could see in Pattadakallu is Virupaksha temple. And this temple was built by Queen Loka Mahadevi in the memory of three victories over by Pallavas by Vikramaditya. So here if you see this temple looks like it is being held by lions and elephants holding the beams, and we could see a huge sculpture of Nandi and in the Nandi Mantapa in front of this temple. And this temple also has Mukhamantapa, Mahamantapa and Garbhagriha has a Shikara, and this Garbhagriha Shikara was in Dravida style. So this is one of the important feature of Pattadakallu. So where the temple looks like being held by lions and elephants holding the beams, and also we can see the sculpture of Nandi, and the temple has Mukhamantapa, Mahamantapa and Garbhagriha. So these are the temples of Chalukyan art. So next let us see what about the literature. So if you see the literature, Sanskrit and Kannada were well developed. Though most of the inscriptions of those days are in Sanskrit, the script was in Kannada language. So let us see few of the poets and what were their important works. So the first we see is Vijay Mahadevi, that is Kaumudi Mahotsava, Shiva Bhattarika. So he wrote Haraparavartiya, and Ravi Kirti wrote Aihole Prashasti, and Pujapada wrote Shabdavatara. So these are the poets and their important works, and Sanskrit and Kannada language were well developed during this Chalukyan period. So last thing we see is regarding the religion. So if you see about the religion, Chalukyas were Vaishnavites. So here, how can we say they were Vaishnavites? So we could see different incarnations of Vishnu. So what are the different incarnations of Vishnu? So they are the Varaha, Narasimha, Trivikrama. So these incarnations were carved in the temples which were built by Mangalesha. And later what happened? So initially these Chalukyans were Vaishnavites. So later they gave up Vaishnavism and they became the followers of Shaivism. So here you could see the, how can you say that they became the followers of Shaivism? Here, the queens of Vikramaditya, they built two famous Shiva temples. So, what are the two famous Shiva temples? They were Lokeshwara temple and Trilokeshwara temple at Pattadakal. So, not only Vaishnavism and Shaivism, we could also see the Jainism that also received generous encouragement. And with this generous encouragement, many villages were gifted as grants for the development of Jaina temples and centers of education. So this is all about the religion. That means they believed, initially they were Vaishnavites. Next they gave up Vaishnavism and followed Shaivism. And even though Vaishnavism and Shaivism were there, so Jainism also received generous encouragement. So this is all about the religion. So this is all about the architecture. religion and literature. Hope you understood this particular video or the lesson. So if you like this lesson, please do click on the like button. And if you want to receive the further notification, please click on the bell button or subscribe to the channel. And if you have any suggestions, you can just comment it, comment in the comment section of the video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.